myself within.
Hi, this is Reese.
And this is Sophie.
And welcome back to our Evil Within commentary series. We are currently on chapter 3 of the game, and we've split this one into two parts. This is the second of which.
In the first, we found a village, we disarmed some bombs, found Chainsaw Man in a barn.
Discussed brains.
And yeah, now we're still in that barn, and we need to try and find a way out of that level to go find Leslie, because everyone wants to know where Leslie's at.
Yeah, the immediate focus is we were trying to get past one of these zombies that had a gun, so we were kind of trying to find a back way around through the buildings to get past him.
So let's see how well Reese does in this next part of the game. I love how you keep coming back into this barn, even though he's in here.
I was just waiting for him to break free, and I didn't want me to be like completely off guard when it happened.
You wanted to be in here when it happened.
Yeah. Also, I hadn't explored up here, so I knew I had to come back here eventually.
I know you're very good at exploring. In these kind of games, I'm just like, I want to get out of here.
There you are. You can see his enchants.
Oh, there's a chest there.
Yeah.
So I assume that you can break down the wall that's between you and him and get in the chest.
Yeah. Well, again, that was my thinking at this point in the game, which is why I was like, I'm going to explore before I try taking on the chainsaw guy, who's most likely going to kill me. And see, there's more of them. Loads of them out there. Two of them just there.
Is this the area that you were talking about earlier when you said that they kept spawning?
Yes. And this is where I didn't know how many of my...
Oh!
I don't know where that bomb came from.
What is that noise?
I think they heard the bomb go off.
Oh, so they're all gonna file in here.
Yeah.
Get up those ladders!
That's them breaking down the door right now. There they are. See them? Oh, you see one of their arms?
Yeah. You need to heal yourself. I hope you noticed that.
I think I do notice that one. I think that one was a pretty obvious one.
You haven't used any healing yet.
Again, it was a case of I didn't know how much we'd get. So I was kind of making use of the fact that when you're at that much health, you kind of heal up to that point.
I love how you thought, like me, you were like, get up the ladder, they're coming through, but now you're up here. What do you do?
What can I do from here?
Look at those shadows.
Yeah.
They're so good.
Oh, I do use healing here.
Oh yeah, you've got to face the horde of zombies.
There's at least one of them in here. Well, technically two if you count chainsaw guy.
We're so imaginative with our name. Chainsaw.
Nah, here she comes.
Ah, police cop, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Or a paramedic? I thought you were going to hide in that then. I was like, that is some impressive hiding.
Gotta favour the shotgun.
I would have gone with the hatchet, you know, considering there's only one enemy.
Clearly I wasn't thinking that resourceful at the time. Yeah, learned my lesson after last time.
She makes a lot of noise.
Just reminds me of Mass Effect, that's yeah, why they had the glitch and they were flying through the air after having a biotic attack on them and
they
were just screaming.
They wouldn't stop screaming. So, does Chainsaw Matt, does he follow you through the levels?
Not all of them, but he does recur. So we've got...
Where did all of those zombies come from? Because that yard was clear when you came into this building.
It was completely clear when we started this level off, and like I say, I was wondering if I was meant to have burnt more of the bodies while they were still dormant, and they've just been waking up over the, you know, the time we've been on this level.
there's a lot to explore.
Yeah. Like I say, this kind of chapter feels like you're in a bit of a sandbox almost.
Mm.
You've got your end objective, but there's a lot of other things you can do.
May I just say, we've walked through this barn a lot of times and none of us have mentioned the pig. I feel like the pig should probably get a mention.
Okay then, shout out to the pigs.
Why are they still alive?
How have they survived this long? Why have the zombies not eaten them?
So zombies don't eat pigs, that's what we've learned.
Not in this world. Pigs have too many brains.
Yeah. I just love how that pig's on its own in that barn.
With chainsaw man.
Yeah, not fast.
Around.
It's not fast. He's got enough hay there to live.
To last him a lifetime. Is that what pigs eat?
Hay. Hey, I think pigs eat anything.
There we are. Sound out in the comments. What do pigs eat?
What do pigs eat? Everything or anything? I think they can eat hay.
I have absolutely no idea. I'm not very well educated on
pigs.
Farmyard animals.
I'm not well educated on farmyard animals. That should be a new subject at school. This is an interesting build. We haven't been in here, have we?
No.
I'm so disoriented without a map or like...
I couldn't go forward, could I? Because there was that enemy that had the gun. So I've had to try and sneak around the back. Always beware of the traps in this game.
Were you two meant to do that in sync?
No, I think I want to know what the lever did. I'm assuming both levers do the same thing. In fact, no, I now know that both levers do the same thing. But I just saw a lever and was like, pull the lever!
Because it looked like you guys had like synced there.
Ah!
Well, she walked into that, didn't she?
What made you think that one was a she?
Wasn't it wearing a dress?
No, I don't think so. I don't know. I didn't see it properly. I thought it was one of those topless male ones with like no face.
I don't know, because you burnt them to death. they've disintegrated now.
Yeah, he's
ashes. Never know.
It's
if anybody
ashes.
Watching this caught what gender that was, let us know. We're in disagreement. Another shotgun.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know where the first one came from, but the second one you pick up from a chest. I don't remember picking up a chest in the last chapter, so...
No, you literally came out of the river with a shotgun. Oh, where'd that writing come from?
He's watching. We can't leave.
Ooh, who's watching? I hear feet.
I think the worst thing is,
zombies,
yeah,
actually.
It's the noises that get you.
I would have kept that tripwire in if there wasn't you just running here.
I think that's what I do.
I'd always be conscious of what's behind me.
Lead
them back to the tripwire. Or not, no. Ah, I see.
I don't... recall this working. No.
Nah, you were too soon.
You know, I thought I was about to run into it then. That'd be shameful.
It would be shameful. Oh, old lady knitting needles!
Is no more.
I wonder why they have glowing eyes.
I'm not sure if that's necessarily explained. And that was definitely the sound of a door opening. Oh, yeah, there's another one. No more tripwire to lead them to.
Too soon again. I feel like there's going to be more coming to the left of you.
Like I say, I can't remember. It was too long ago that I played this. That I recorded this footage.
Yeah, Reese decided to play this game at night. With headphones on in the dark.
Yeah, but that's the crazy kind of person that I am.
I'm finding it scary in the light.
There you are, harpoon bolts.
Now they look pretty awesome.
On the smaller enemies, I think they actually it pins them to the wall when they get, if there's a wall behind them, they go flying when you hit them with that. And there we are, there's the agony crossbow.
Now, is that probably your most preferred weapon of the game?
No. I would say that I tend to default back to the revolver because I've always liked having pistols and the like in these kind of games. I prefer having smaller guns, even though in this game I seem to be using the shotgun all the time.
Yeah, you see, in most games I am...
I'm ashamed of that.
No, that was a bad shot. I'm usually a shotgun user. But the handgun is a trusty gun to fall back on.
It's the one you tend to get the most ammo with, and unlike things like the shotgun, you can use it at medium to maybe long range, depending on the gun and the game. Might as well burn that body, seeing as I've got another match I can pick up over there.
So we've now dispatched that zombie that was shooting us, so we should be able to go open the gate. I love how there's no zombies outside now that you've killed the one with the gun.
I'm sure there's still some more sneaking around.
Because that courtyard was filled with them.
Then again, how many were dispatched in this building? How many seem to have crawled in or knocked doors down?
Actually, quite a lot. There has been quite a lot of zombies in this building.
They probably all just somehow managed to find me in here. Oh!
Oh, nice find! I didn't see that. It was blending in with the brick.
Yeah,
no, I have no idea where the key fell.
I have no idea where the key fell. I'm looking around now going, now where did that go?
Oh, no! Oh, there it is.
There it is.
You could have made them shiny or something.
Everything else is shiny. Brain juice is shiny.
Is he actually going to lift
it? Great.
No.
There's got to be something that'll get through this. Maybe a chainsaw or something.
Oh, no. So that's why...
You know
why,
what's coming now.
That's why we go back to the chainsaw man.
Yeah.
To steal his chainsaw. It's handy that he's just in the barn tied up for us, isn't it?
It's almost as if someone wanted us to succeed.
Now, when you say it like that, it makes me think that someone wants us to succeed. And there's a higher power here.
It is. It's called game developers.
Yeah, game developers want you to succeed. If this was a real weird thing going on, we would not get through the gate. Then again, there was that guy at the mental hospital, which we haven't really thought of since, with the hood on.
Ruvik.
Yes, and he's meant to be the antagonist to this game. We haven't seen him since. I love how instead of going for the chainsaw, you're going to go check out what happened to the doctor.
Well, yeah, we just haven't found out what happened to the doctor yet, have we?
No.
And there's all your zombies from the courtyard. They're still out there.
Well, he didn't last long, did he?
Not going to lie, that is one of my favourite weapons. You asked me about the crossbow thing, that's probably my favourite weapon.
That's when your favourite weapon?
When you get one of those torches, they're my favourite weapons.
What did that lever do?
I'm honestly not sure. I didn't see what that one did. I don't know what I'm looking for at this
point. I don't
know
what you're looking for.
Unless I'm just thinking, why are there so many creepy sounds coming from this building?
I love how you're like, there's some ammo here, I will use one of my bolts.
No, because if you flick to the bolt that you're full of, then it lets you pick up another one. Because it's then loaded into the crossbow.
I see. So can you only carry one bolt at a time?
At the beginning I think it's like two, which means you can carry one and have one loaded. And then you upgrade it so you can carry more. I think that was how it worked. Maybe you could carry two and have one loaded.
It's quite a cumbersome weapon, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh. Nice, Reese. Nice.
Like I say, I've got to, when I did this bit, it wasn't a blind playthrough. I had sort of seen
someone else play it.
Yeah.
See.
So I won't take credit.
Good job you admitted to that. Otherwise, I'd be like, you're so good at this game.
No, because on my original files, when you look at the recording dates, if you look at them, the first two chapters were recorded in one day, and then this one was recorded on a different day, which was about 3 or 4 days after.
Do you have to pick up his pickaxe?
No. It literally fades away in front of your eyes. You kill the enemy, the enemy's weapons go with him.
It's unfair, that. Mm. And there's still no sign of the Doctor. Unless he's in this room, that open room.
Yeah.
Oh my. There he is.
How did you get it open so quickly?
You're welcome to give it a try.
Please, time is of the essence. It is imperative
we find Leslie sense of humor.
Anything should happen to him.
Now, why is this Doctor so concerned with Leslie?
No.
Why are you looking at her skirt? What? Reese!
I have no idea what was going on. I think I was deciding whether I wanted to burn the body or not. Because we've seen...
I'm sorry, I love the physics.
And look,
there.
I put a match down, didn't burn her.
It's because she's floating in the air. Waste of a match.
Experiment number 4. Subject numbers 4 through 13. Brainwave activity diminished, but synchronization achieved. Subjects should begin experiencing a shared consciousness. Previous trials indicated rapid deterioration of consciousness. Their minds became an exquisite mass, an amalgam of mental carrion. I'll have to connect myself if I want to experience their terror before it diminishes.
Whose voice is that?
I don't know if I should just tell you now or wait for the game to kind of tell you. Which would you prefer?
I think I'm going to guess.
Okay, you go
is
ahead.
Is that
guess.
Ruvik?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so clever.
Even though we've never heard him speak, you knew that was Ruvik.
I knew it was Ruvik. Because, I don't know, I felt like that was a very baddie-like recording.
Mm.
Only someone evil would say something. I mean, so does that mean Ruvik was the main doctor? He was working on patients sharing consciousnesses.
Mm-hmm.
So he was a doctor, and I
not a doctor per se, but, you know, like a scientist.
Yeah. And now he's got a hood and he looks all weird. Which makes me think he hooked into the consciousnesses of the two patients that he was just discussing, and it went terribly wrong. Maybe we're in their shared consciousness right now. This is what those two patients together have.
So is it just us that is there, or is it all of our police partners as well? When did this start?
Well, I think it's us. I think Sebastian used to be a detective. After that case with the serial killer who was a doctor and chopped up bodies, after that case, they never actually found that killer. It disturbed him on a level. And he went to a mental hospital, and then he has been tested on with Leslie, and they've got joint consciousness.
Good theory.
And Ruvik's just entered the show. Because he's the psycho doctor behind it all. And all of this is just in his mind, and it's his mind mixed with Leslie's. What do you think?
I like the theory.
It's not right though, is it?
I'm gonna let the game tell you what's actually happening. I won't just go out and tell you. But I do like the theory. I had a very similar theory at the beginning that it was going to be something to do with he was at the hospital, or a patient at the hospital, mm-hmm. got roped into this whole brain synchronization experiment, and from there you are now playing those experiences while he's in that state.
That would make sense that when he goes through the mirrors he's locked up, because that's his memory of actually being a patient. That's when he sees his true self, almost.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I was linking it a lot to those mirrors. So now it's a case of, how do we get the chainsaw?
Oh, no.
That's how.
I love how your first thought is, I'm just going to shoot him with a crossbow. To be fair, that's how you used to take out chainsaw men and risk people.
Yeah. He just doesn't respond to it.
No. I don't think you're going to survive. Do you survive?
I can't remember.
He's too fast.
He is. That was one of the fireballs that I had.
Now that was effective.
Yeah, just have to run into a circle to get it to affect him. Now he's coming.
This feels a lot like Resident Evil's Mercenaries right now.
Well, you've got one of those enemies that you just can't kill.
Oh no,
Reese! Epic fail!
This is when it all goes wrong now.
Yeah.
So why did you opt for the crossbow? Is it because you'd watched someone else do it this way?
No, this is because I watched how my friend did it, and then I was trying to do it a bit differently to see if it worked any better.
You killed him.
There we go. Got him.
Because my... He died in a weird way.
Very weird way.
So the Chainsaw Man was actually Ruvik.
I better hold on to this.
Or part of Ruvik, or some kind of manifestation from Ruvik. Yeah.
So maybe we're tied with him. Maybe there is no other patient. Maybe it's just him and
Sebastian. What, is everyone else not real, or...?
I think they're real insofar as the imagination. Like, they are real people in the real world, but in this world they're just manifestations of what Sebastian remembered them to be.
Fair enough. Interesting theory. I would say consider the notes and things that we found about the brainwave experiment to be early phases, and they've added more to the scale of it.
So, when I say there's only two of them...
You're limiting your theories.
Which means maybe all of them that are in this world are actually linked together.
Mm-hmm.
But why would they have created such a messed up place? Is this what happens when consciousnesses join? The first thing everyone thinks of is, oh my god, zombie apocalypse. Let's all go live in that world for a bit. My consciousness would be full of Mass Effect and Dragon Age. There'd be dragons and aliens everywhere.
Unless someone's maybe more influential than others.
Oh, so their mind rules over everyone else's because they're more powerful. And they're obviously quite sadistic.
I shouldn't be trying to drive your theories so much.
Well, I think I'm close. I'm just limiting myself.
I'm just giving you a couple more ideas. At this point in the game, I remember that I thought that everyone's brains were somehow linked in this experiment.
Mm.
And weirdness was ensuing.
I love how you still haven't used your chainsaw yet.
I don't know what I'm looking for at this point. I've got no idea what I'm looking for at this point.
It's interesting how you never see the shotgun on him, but when he has the crossbow, that's on his back, and you see the handgun, but you never see the shotgun.
Yeah, I think... I never noticed that, but I'm sure I remember seeing the shotgun on him. Here we are, we're using the chainsaw now.
Would that work, do you think?
What, in real life? I've got no idea. If it was in my brain world, it would probably work.
It would probably work. I'd have super strength in my brain world.
Wait! Over here! Wait, officer. You must take me with you.
Detective Castellanos.
Leslie should be just ahead. It is imperative.
He's sensitive about that. He's a detective, not an officer.
And why is it imperative that they find Leslie?
There's something important about him, or at least to the doctor there is.
And that's that chapter cleared.
So, what do you think to how that's kind of progressed?
Yeah, I felt like a lot more happened in that chapter, but I still feel like nothing was answered. Though I do have a couple more theories on what is going on, more so than I did before. And I like the interlude back in, like, the mental... You know, when you go through the mirror?
Yeah.
That was nice. I feel like when you go through there, you learn quite a lot.
Mm, yeah. I thought the audio recording that you found in that chapter definitely was...
Cleared some stuff up.
Yeah, it kind of gave you a bit more of an insight into what was going on, especially how after you find that recording, you then see Ruvik again, so you kind of put the two together.
So that was good. I feel like we're progressing through the chapters.
And you can kind of see from that chapter a bit more how the gameplay mechanics work, because it wasn't a tutorial chapter, it wasn't just a story opening chapter, it was a bit more of a... it was a bit more of a sandbox, wasn't it?
Yeah,
there was a point end point, but it was more open ended.
You had to think a lot on your feet of what weapons to use, manage your resources.
Yeah,
you did really well. You didn't die, that was surprising.
I'm quite happy that I didn't die.
Not that I don't have faith in your playing.
Until later chapters, you'll then see me die quite a bit.
So I guess that was the end of chapter 3, part 2, and
thank you very much for watching.
Please like, subscribe, comment, and share the video.
Until next time.
Bye.
Bye.